students, this is your Bhushan sir. During this pandemic time, hope all of you are safe and fine at home. Today, we shall study the morphology or externals of planaria, technically called as Dujicia, under the type study of phylum Platyhelminthes. The type study generally refers to the study of an animal that includes classification, habits, habitats, physiology, anatomy, embryology, and evolutionary genetics. In this regard, we need to concentrate on the type study of planaria, technically called as Dujicia, as the example under Platyhelminthes. Dujicia tigrina is commonly called as planaria. The objectives that we are going to understand today is related to the morphological features of planaria and those structures which makes the animal adaptive to the habitat in which it lives. The content part that we are going to understand is the morphological features of planaria. Well, students, Dujicia is a free-living freshwater form of Platyhelminthes or flatworms. It lives in groups, hence are called gregarious. Its dwelling place or habitat is underside the leaves, logs, then even on the submerged rocks, which we find in the freshwater bodies like ponds, lakes, rivers, the water which is clean in nature. Down in the picture of the slide, you can find planaria attaching to a dead leaf. Planaria is mostly invisible to identify. It is not because of its size, but it is related to its activities. Unless the planaria shows the movement, we cannot find that there is an existence of planaria organism in the water. The reason being, the color of the organism blends with the color of the background on which it is. And coming on to the distribution of this animal, it is worldwide in distribution. The shape of Dujicia is elongated, worm-like. The size is around 12 millimeters of long, and the color is ranges from dark brownish to blackish color. Coming on to the structural details, it is a thin platform having two polarities. One is anterior-posterior. Anterior-posterior refers to top to bottom. The second polarity is dorso-ventral, that is upper and lower surfaces. Generally, the dorsal surface is tend to face the water upside, whereas the ventral surface of the animal is towards the substratum on which it is going to bind or attach. Dorsal surfaces tend to have the darker color, and the ventral surface will have lighter color comparatively. Now, coming on to the anterior-posterior polarity. The anterior end refers to the end where the head of the animal is present, and that shows the movement of the organism towards it. So the directed, forward-directed position of the movement is indicated by the anterior end, and exactly the opposite end is called as the posterior end. So here in the diagram down, you can find the head showing the anterior end and the tail, tail of the body showing the posterior end. And towards the right extreme, we have the ventral surface, and towards the left extreme, we have the dorsal surface depicting the polarities. Now, coming on to the morphological details of Dujicia. So, when we say morphology, it refers to the external appearance of the animal. So, we are allowed to comment on the structures that are appearing to us both at the polarity of anterior to posterior and then dorsal to ventral. So, in this regard, we are going to start with the anterior polarity. So, the anterior end of the organism shows the presence of the head. The head structure is roughly triangular with two laterally projected extensions which are called as head lobes or auricles. They act as the organs of chemoreceptors, mean to say they are very sensitive for the chemicals. The head is separated by the body by means of a neck-like constriction. There is a narrowing of a part between the head and the body. That narrowing part we call it as the neck region. The body is roughly elongated, leaf-like, and its posterior end shows a pointed end. The dorsal, coming onto the dorsal surface and the ventral surfaces of the body of organism. Generally, the dorsal surface of the organism of Dujicia is slightly arched, it is slightly curved, whereas the ventral surface is said to be flat. So that's the importance of anteroposterior polarity and dorsoventral polarity. Down towards the right extreme of the second diagram in this slide indicates how exactly a cross-section of the body of Dujicia looks like. The down structure, when you look here, it is flat. Whereas the dorsals, that indicates the ventral surface. And the upper surface is slightly arched. And that indicates the dorsal surface. Now, onto the dorsal surface, when we look at, the animal shows certain of special structures on the head as well as body. The head region consists of presence of two cup-shaped black eye spots, which are seen at mid part of the head region, at anterior position. So these eye spots are the indications of the dorsal surface of the organism again. Then, towards the body, when we come, when we look at the organism, at the ventral surface of the body, there is an oval or round aperture of the opening that indicates the presence of the mouth that is surrounded by a sheath or covering called as pharyngeal covering, from which there is the protrusion of the structure called as the pharynx. Pharynx is a cylindrical tube that moves out of the pharyngeal sheath and the mouth. So this structure, when the pharynx moves out of the body, it looks like the trunk or the proboscis of an elephant, hence the name proboscis given for this particular structure. So we find towards the dorsal side, structures of the head contains the eye spots, which are pale black colored cup-shaped structures. Towards the ventral surface, we have another important organ called the mouth and surrounded by the pharyngeal sheath, which indicates the presence of ventral surface. Then, coming on to the next important identification of dorsal and ventral surfaces. So the dorsal, the ventral surface surrounding the region of the mouth is the presence of cilia. So you have the mouth structure surrounded by a group of cilia at the central location. On either sides of this mid-ciliated zone, we have a structure referred as adhesive zone. So adhesive refers to the structure that involves in the attachment of the organism to the substratum. So it's a sticky substance producing zone. So this adhesive zone is seen at two lateral margin areas at ventral location. So you can see here in the diagram towards the right side, it is labeled as C diagram here, indicating the presence of adhesive zones towards the lateral margin area. So presence of adhesive zone at lateral margin on the ventral surface is another identification of the polarity of ventral surface. The next is the animal also shows the presence of the mucus glands. As the animal keeps moving, when planaria keeps moving on the substratum, it leaves a trail mark of the mucus. So it will leave a path marking of the mucus. So it is because of secretion of the mucus done by the mucus glands present on the ventral surface again. So these are all the indications by which we can enmark the ventral surface of the body of the organism. Then, above the mouth area, there is one more aperture called as the genital aperture, through which the sexually matured forms of the organism comes out, or gametic cells sometimes even comes out. So the importance of the mucus gland and the presence of presence of genital aperture also indicates the presence of the ventral surface of the body of the animal. Now, there is also another indication by which we can identify the dorsal surface and ventral surface. It is by looking at the cross-section of the body of organism. So when we take the cross-section of the body of Dugesia, it shows the presence of an outer covering called as the epidermis, what we have learned in the previous session. So the outer epidermis is made up of single layer thickened cuboidal epithelial cells, and these cells are generally ciliated all over the body in few species of planaria. But in case of Dugesia tigrina, as the type study animal, what we are studying here, it shows the presence of cilia only to the mid position of ventral location. So that's what we have understood here just now. At the ventral surface, at surrounding the region of the mouth, you have a zone at present at the middle location with the cilia. So the middle ciliary zone you find here. So you can find the ciliary zone at mid location of the ventral surface. So towards the lateral sides of this ventral surface shows the presence of the mucus secreting cells. And along with this, you can also find towards the dorsal surface, the epithelial cells producing the mucus, as well as has a special kind of glassy protein content in the cells called as rhabditis material. So rhabditis refers to special kind of glassy materials present within the epithelial cells. So they give a kind of protection for the organism, since they don't have any other covering and it's a free living organism. So that's about the importance of ventral surface. Coming on to the dorsal surface, we find the presence of marginal lateral openings, which are seen on the dorsal surface. They are the openings through which the excretory waste comes out of the body. They are called as excretory pores, or dorsal pores, or nephridiopores. So we will look into this particular aspect a little later in detail. Here, for time being, you will have to know these are all the characters by which you can easily identify the dorsal surface and the ventral surface related to Dugesia. So that's about the importance of morphology related to Dugesia. Students, remember, we have learnt about the color of the organism, size of the organism. Then we also have learnt about the shape of the organism, the habitat and habit where it lives, and then the structural details pertaining to anteroposterior axis and dorsoventral axis. So this, with this, we are completing the morphology related to Dugesia. Well, students, after we understanding the concept of morphology, to test our ability of understanding, here are a few MCQs, the multiple choice questions. Let us see how well we are able to answer these questions and how to what an extent we have understood the topic today. So to what class do planaria belong? The classification. So we have learned the classification. Planaria belongs to phylum, platyhelminthes, and classes, Turbellaria. So answer is D, Turbellaria. The next question. What are the chemoreceptors present in planaria called? Where are the chemoreceptors? The sensitive structures for the chemicals are present. They are present in the auricle. So answer is B. Planaria is a dash complex animal. So here are the options: triploblastic, diploblastic, unicellular, and small. We know that platyhelminth, all platyhelminth is comes under triploblastic condition. So planaria is also a triploblastic animal. So the answer is A. The locomotory structures present in planaria are called flagella, cilia, pseudopodia, and auricles. The right answer is cilia, present on the mid-ventral surface of the body of organism. So answer is B. The pharynx that can be everted through the mouth is called. So protrusion of the pharynx, it resembles the structure of what? The proboscis of an elephant. Hence the right answer is proboscis C. The next question. The part of the body that helps in clinging of planaria to the substratum, clinging refers to attachment, is to which particular through which particular surface the animal binds to the substratum? It is to the ventral surface. And what is the part that helps in adhesion, that is attachment? It is the marginal adhesive zone that secretes the adhesive substance. So the answer is B. What exactly have we learned from the session today? We have understood about the unique morphological features pertaining to planaria, and also we have learned how well these structures, special structures present on the animal, helps them to have the habitat selection or adaptation to the nature. Here are a few references. The web references are Wikipedia and Britannica. And book references, the textbook references are Invertebrate Zoology by P.S. Verma and Modern Textbook of Zoology by Kotpal. Well, students, if you have any queries and comments, please post it to my WhatsApp number. Stay at home. Take care of your health. Thank you all.